One more comment, my dear brothers and sisters. It is about an article written in the Saudi newspaper, Al-Sharq Al-Awsat, 10 days ago. You all remember that 2 weeks ago, millions of people have completed the ziyarah of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Some estimations say 15 million, some say 20 million, whatever it is. It was, according to many observers, it was the largest human gathering on earth. The largest, by far. Millions of people flocked in Karbala to visit Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So, and instead of praising the peace, the serenity in which those people performed performed ziyarah, a Saudi newspaper decided to make a very hurtful injury and insult by claiming that there were over 169 illegitimate pregnancy during the ziyarah, attributing that to the World Health Organization, implying that people who are going to ziyarah were committing adultery, wal-iyadu billah. My dear brothers and sisters, I don't want to take too much time in responding to this attack, but I would like to say one thing, that look, the hatred for Ahlul Bayt, the hatred for Imam Hussein alayhi salam would push some people to make such horrific accusations against Muslims who are going peacefully to visit the shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. That's so petty and so disgraceful. But I would like to tell this newspaper, the Saudi paper, that the illegitimate pregnancy, don't look for the illegitimate pregnancies in Karbala during the ziyarah. Rather, look for the illegitimate pregnancies in the royal palaces of Al Saud. I'm sure there are many of them there. I'm sure that so much adultery, fornication is taking place in these palaces in Saudi Arabia. And don't talk about innocent people, religious people, devout people who abandon their livelihood to come walking on their feet to visit Imam Hussein. Talk about your own people. There was a new study, statistics, saying that 90% of children in Riyadh, the capital of Saudi Arabia, have been sexually assaulted by their own relatives. So go check yourself. Don't talk about the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. And this is very especially painful, that when the Saudis use this kind of rhetoric against other Muslims, baseless accusations, indeed all they are doing, they are adding the oil to fire. In fact, today, if you have access to internet, go check it yourself. Go to the website of the Israeli newspaper, Haaretz, in which it says that the Prime Minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu, extended his gratitude to King Salman of Saudi Arabia for extending hand of help by extinguishing the fire that was raging in Israel lately. Saudi Arabia sent teams fighting fire in Israel to help the Israelis to cope with the fire. And that's why Israel is so grateful to Saudi Arabia. What do you read in that, my dear brothers and sisters? What do you read other than the fact that this regime, the Saudi regime, is nothing but an ally to the Zionists and to Israel, an avowed enemy to Muslims themselves? And I don't care if they carry the flag of Islam, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. That is a conspicuous hypocrisy that Saudi Arabia has been practicing for over 80 years so far.